Hey guys, it's Monica at Academic Phoenix Plus, and welcome to another ZBrush tutorial. So in the last tutorial, we went over how to bring something in from Maya and detail it into ZBrush. This time we're going to start from scratch in ZBrush, get it ready to go, and then we'll retopo it in Maya. Again, these are just two different methods to get to the same goal, which is to create a low and a high poly model so that we can bake it. And I will be demonstrating all of that in another tutorial. So that being said, let's go ahead and get started and start modeling in ZBrush from scratch. So here we are, and you can see that we are in the light box, and I'm just gonna grab a cube, just a regular cube. And you can already tell that we're in edit mode and in draw mode. And one of the things I wanted to show you in this tutorial is that if you hit W, E, or R, you'll notice that we activate move, scale, and rotate. So just like Maya, W, E, R. If you click on the letter Q, it will go back to draw, which will give you access to the brushes, the strokes, and the alphas. I'm gonna go ahead and activate scale, and I can just grab this and just like Maya, just bring it up and make it a little bit longer. I'm gonna create a sci-fi crate, which I forgot to mention earlier, but in this video, we're gonna be creating a very simple sci-fi crate. Just to get some details down, I'm gonna show you a couple of new tools and show you how quickly you can create a sci-fi crate and then bring it into Maya for retopo. All right, so here's my crate. Now you can move it up and down. You can rotate it if you want to, but I always recommend that you toggle your camera to look at your model, not rotate your object. Press Q. Cool. All right, so now we have our crate, or at least the basis of a crate. And what I wanted to show you is how to make selection with a mask. So if I hold down Control and I click and drag, and you'll notice that symmetry is active. If I go to the other side, you'll notice that they look a little bit different, but at the top view, you'll also notice that it's not exactly straight. And the reason why is because of the perspective. So right now, this is the perspective that we have. This is kind of like the Maya perspective, which gives us depth. But we really want is an orthographic view, which is kind of like in Maya, the front, side, or top view. Well, ZBrush can give us this by turning off dynamic perspective. By turning that off, everything's gonna look a little bit weirder, but it is flatter. So let me demonstrate to you what I mean. So I'm gonna hold down Control, click and drag out here in space. That will clear the mask. And I'm gonna hold down Shift to make sure I'm looking at it in the front view. And again, I'm gonna hold down Control, click and drag. And now you'll notice that the top and the back, the selection is straight. I'm gonna turn dynamic on because it's a little bit easier to see. All right, I'm gonna go to the top view, and another way you guys can get to the top view is by clicking these buttons here, which will kind of snap it back into place, just like holding down Shift, except it's up maybe with a little bit more control. And now I'm looking at the top view. Now if I hold down Control and then Alt, and then I can click and drag, and now I have deselected the top and the bottom. Great. And why am I doing this? Because I want to show you guys another tool, which is called deformation. Now, before I get started, though, I really want to increase my mesh count. Right now, it's a 24,000. So let's go ahead and deselect our mask. Let's give ourselves more divisions. First, I'm going to delete the lower because I'm not going to go any lower geometry than this. Then I'm going to divide two more times. This is going to get me up to 393,000 poly. So that should be pretty good. Let's make sure dynamic is off. Make sure we're looking at the front view. And make your selection. Double check, make sure everything's good. Let's go to the top view, hit F, and then Control Alt, click and drag. All right, cool. Turn that perspective back on, hit F, nice. All right, great. I'm gonna hit Control Click on the empty space, which will flip my mask. And then I'm gonna show you a new tool, which is known as deformation. Deformation has some really great tools, and one of them is called Inflate Balloon. If I go to Inflate Balloon and I start bringing this out a little bit, you'll notice that it starts inflating it like a balloon. Now, this is really cool, but you have to be careful. It's kind of, it's a little bit too much. So you can either just try to control it by dragging this and just kind of observing it, or you can actually type the value in by clicking on the word and just typing in, for example, the value of 10. So this is nice because it gives us geometry and a shape right away. All right, so let me show you the negative version of that. So again, I'm going to make a selection by holding down Control, click and drag. Oh, as you can see, I didn't have dynamic. So it's really important to rotate your model to make sure everything's looking good. Turn off the dynamic perspective. All right, cool. I'm gonna make a deselection by holding down Control Alt. Cool. Turn it back on because it looks better in this perspective. I'm going to flip thy mask by, again, holding down control and clicking on the empty space. And this time I'm going to inflate balloon, but in the negative. And you're going to notice that, if I go too far, it kind of breaks it. But if I can control it just slowly but truly, I can actually push this backwards until it can't anymore. So around negative 8. We also have taper, which we can just kind of go in and drag it a little bit to the bottom. So it tapers the mesh a little bit. And we also have other things that you guys can kind of mess around with. But in this case, I'm okay with where we are right now. Just kind of play around with the different types of tools you can use under deformation. All right, cool. Now I do want whatever I do to the left side happen to the right side. So let's go ahead and turn on Z under transform. And then I'm going to grab the trim dynamic and just kind of flatten this a little bit. So I'm just going to go in and just try to round that shape a little bit. So I'm just kind of digging in a little bit just to smooth it out. Hold down shift, which will give me my smooth, and just kind of smooth it out. So as you can see, ZBrush can give you all sorts of shapes. You can get sharp shapes. You can get smooth shapes. Really up to you how you want to use it. All right, nice. I'm going to hold down control, click and drag, and that's going to release the mask. All right, let's create something on the side. So like before, I'm going to turn off the perspective and holding down control. I'm just going to go ahead and make a couple of selections here. And then I'm going to hold down alt and make a deselection. Reverse the mask. This time under deformation, I'm going to choose, instead of inflate balloon, I'm going to choose inflate. So that's going to kind of give me a little bit of an indentation inward. So very quickly, we can get a really cool looking sci-fi crate. All right, so next is more detailing. So we have our silhouette. Our silhouette looks like this up here at the top, which is how I'm going to retopologize it. But eventually, we're going to get into the point where we're going to need details. And these details are not going to be really modeled. They're going to be used in textures. So that's one of the things that you have to consider is, when you are ready to retopologize it, you're going to be looking at is at the silhouette, the things that stick out and stick in. But when it comes to details like screws and other things that really don't stick out, then you probably want to use it as a texture map. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how to create all of the details. In another tutorial, I'll show you guys how to bake. All right, let's start off by giving ourselves some details. Let's grab our standard brush here. And we do have a couple of alphas we can choose. So for example, let's say maybe I want this alpha map. Now you'll notice under my transform, I have X and Y and Z active. So that means that whatever I do to one side is going to happen to the other. So that's going to be really nice and helpful as I continue working on this. Let's grab the drag rectangle so I can click and drag and create details. And that's okay. I'm not a big fan of that, but let's put this detail at the top. So I'm going to go ahead and click and drag. And don't forget, you can always hold on alt to create a negative indentation. I think my intensity is a little too strong, so reduce that. And again, click and drag. I really have a limited amount of alphas. What can I do? Well, you can import your own alphas. I demonstrated to you in a previous tutorial, but I'm going to show you again. Let's go to import. And I already have downloaded some alphas. So I'm going to bring in the first one. And it looks like a little screw. And I'm going to put it, let's see, maybe right over here. And you'll notice that I'm starting to not have the best geometry. That's not really good looking geometry. So let's go ahead and give ourselves a little bit more by going into our geometry and just divide. So now I'm getting up to the 1 million. So just keep that in mind. Just going to put one around here and then one around here. Just something small. Let me just make those smaller still. Just a little detail. I'm going to increase my Z intensity a little bit and just go ahead and give myself a little, just tiny little details. I'm just looking for details at this point. All right, let me do one here too in the corners. Put some at the bottom too. Might as well make it even all around. All right. Already by just giving these little screws, it's starting to look more like a functioning crate. Let's go ahead and import another one. This one looks like another device. So let's go ahead and place it somewhere. So for example, maybe we want to place it here. If I hold down Alt, I can make a negative impression, or if I leave it alone, I can make a positive. Now you can see that it's kind of coming out a little bit and then reducing, and that's because of the focal shift. So if you want it to be completely flat, just change your focal shift to negative 100, and then you can add it in. My Z depth is a little strong, so let me reduce that. And maybe it's better over here. Cool. Let's take a look at it from afar. All right, great. Let's bring in something else. Let's go to import and let's take a look at this one. This looks more like a fan. So I'm going to go on this side. Now, I don't really need it to double on all sides. So let's go ahead and turn off Z. And that should do it. Great. So again, going to turn off perspective just to make sure everything's even. And then I'm going to place this object here. Now, if you hold down control, you can get a little bit of a negative impression, which is great. Let's try that again. All right, cool. Getting some nice details here. All right, let's bring in something else. Ooh, this one's kind of fun. And if you guys are wondering where did I find these, I am going to show you. But first, let me go ahead and put this on top. So let me make sure that my Z is active. And I click and drag because I think this one's a lot cooler looking. And it's starting to look like a sci-fi crate. Ooh, I love arrows. Arrows are fun because they are seriously just tell you, hey, this is up. So let me go ahead and put that in there, making sure that people, when they see this crate, they're going to be like, this side is up. All right, so where did I find this alpha? So, well, lucky for us, Pixelogic is where I found it. So at pixelogic.com, which are the creators of ZBrush, have a resources and you can download alphas. And I'll put the link below. But if you scroll down, you're going to notice that you have some alphas, which are basically black and white stamps that you can use to create any type of detail. And where I found the ones that I showed you today is under industrial. And you can see that there's a lot more than what I just showed you. And they're actually kind of fun to play around with. So I highly encourage you guys to just grab these and download them and then just kind of have some fun with your sci-fi crate. All right, going back. Now you can make your own brush, by the way. For example, I created my own logo in black and white. So when I click and drag, whoops, I don't want that type of symmetry. Let me turn that off. There we go. Nope, wrong one. Let's see, let me turn off X, but have Z active, click and drag, and I can create my own logo on my crate. Now, again, this is just for fun, but you guys can do your own by converting your image into black and white, and anything white rises and anything black doesn't rise. So let me take a look at the other side. It's definitely mirrored on the other side. So if you don't want that, that means that which I don't. So let me just turn off symmetry altogether and then I'll just do it on my own. So I'm gonna go ahead and click and drag. Put it on the other side. Not perfectly aligned, but that's okay. And now we have a sci-fi crate. Let's go ahead and save. Let's go to save as. Now the question is, where should I save this? I'm gonna be using Maya, so I might as well put everything in a Maya folder. Let's go to Maya and let's go to file, project window. Going to create new and call this sci-fi crate. I have a folder called 3D projects. I'm going to click accept. This is going to create a folder called sci-fi crate, which has all the Maya folders that I need. So I'm going to go ahead and click on save as. Sci-fi crate. I like to put things in assets. So I'm going to put it in ZBrush here, a folder called ZBrush. And this is going to be my sci-fi crate. So again, if somebody opens up my Maya folder, they'll know exactly where everything is located. I also want to export this. So let's go to export and I want to make this into an OBJ and it's already called the sci-fi crates, but I'm going to bring it out here in assets. So I'm going to go ahead and click on save. And this might take a while because again, this is about 1.5 million polygons. That's a pretty good amount. So just click okay and let it do its thing. You'll notice that I now have an NTL file plus a sci-fi crate. And it's about 265 megabytes, which is not bad at all. All right, cool. It has been successfully created, which is exactly what we want to see. Let me turn this on. And that is how to create a model in ZBrush. And the next step is to bring it into Maya to retopologize it. So in the next video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to import that high poly mesh and bring it into Maya so that I can retopologize it, UV map it, and then bake it. So again, it's a jam-packed tutorial, lots to cover, but this is basically the pipeline of how to create something in ZBrush, bring it into Maya, and continue on to texture it using Substance Painter. So hopefully you guys found that helpful. Let me know by leaving a comment below. I know we covered a lot. We covered alphas, we covered how to find them. We also covered how to use deformers, divisions, and so much more. But very quickly, you can create a really fun looking sci-fi crate. If you found this useful, please like and share. That's your message to me, letting me know that you guys like these videos and you want to see more. Also, please subscribe. That is also a way that you can help me out. Take a look at academicphoenixplus.com for free tutorials, free ebooks, free 3D models, and so much more. So take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. Again, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Hopefully you guys are enjoying this. If you want to tag me in social media to show me your work, I would love to see it. Otherwise, keep creating, and I will see you next time.